Everybody, so today I'm going to be doing a highly requested foundation review. This foundation recently released and everyone has been asking me all over Instagram and Twitter and all over social media in general to review it. It released at Gen Beauty in a sense that they were giving away a free bottle to anyone who kind of like lined up and got matched for the foundation. I did not have time to do that, sadly, so I just had to wait till it released on the 15th. And it wasn't in any of my stores yet, so I just ordered from their website. It retails for $39 and it's the Born This Way foundation. The packaging is super cute. This is the first Too Faced foundation I have ever tried. I've tried their Beauty Balm, but I've never tried any of their other face products aside from just like bronzers and stuff, which is more so cheeks, obviously. I picked up shade Natural Beige and it retails for $39. There are 12 shades total and it comes with 1 fluid ounce. The claims of the foundation is as an undetectable medium to full coverage. It also says it's infused with coconut water to replenish your moisture, alpine rose to brighten and promote elasticity, hyaluronic acid to make it look smoother and encourage a youthful appearance. And the tip on the box says, to have an I woke up like this perfection, apply from the center of the face outwards and blend to a full coverage and layer as needed. 100% of people said this foundation blurred their imperfections, 98% said they looked absolutely perfect afterwards or made their skin look perfect, and 97% said it provided natural coverage. So I'm very, very excited about this. I've heard a lot of good things, so let's see how it goes. I have the 7th out of 12 shades. I'm really hoping this works out because I couldn't play with it in stores, so I just had to go with my whole, if it says natural beige, usually 95% of the time it matches, so we are gonna hope so. There is a pump and the shade looks good. Exciting. Very, very cute packaging. Smoked glass. Nice gold rim. I love the packaging. So we are gonna start with some of this. I'll bring you guys in a little closer. It is very full coverage. I'm pretty surprised in that sense. I haven't worn a foundation that is full coverage basically on one coat in a long time. It's very close to full. If anything, you just like need to dab just a tiny bit extra on whatever spot you need it to be really full, and it builds really easily because I have this like really dark acne scar right there right now. Shade wise, it looks good, guys. Now to try it with a flat top. I like the application with the brush better. It just seems to have blended faster and it looks a little more natural than the sponge for some reason. The sponge looks a little heavier. Not sure if too much foundation was used or it's just how it applies with a sponge. The coverage was faster with the sponge, but it doesn't look as good. I feel like this side looks better. It looks more natural per se, while this side looks a lot heavier. I don't know if my face is breaking out, but I have some tiny little bumps, almost like hives starting on my face right now, which is freaking me out because I've never had that reaction to anything. So yeah, that's really weird. But it's only happening on one side of my face. So we're just gonna proceed with this. So for the picture, the shade looks good. It definitely looks like it needs some powder. It's no oil control claim in this foundation. So I'm gonna finish off with some concealer and powder and we're gonna see how this thing wears. Hey guys, so it's been a total of seven and a half hours roughly with this foundation on right now with no touch-ups. And here is the picture. As you can see, I am very shiny and I hate to say it, but it's actually worse in person than I think the picture is capturing it. My nose is like oily, like like oily, like fry an egg oily right now. And I think there's only one other foundation this year that I reviewed, and it was by Physicians Formula. It was like the Touch of Glow foundation, where I ended up this oily by this time. I mean, I always have a little shine, but this is like really oily. Like I saw myself in the mirror and I was like, ooh, definitely need to touch up. The middle of my forehead is definitely shiny. Basically T-zone area next to my cheeks. It feels gross. Yeah, not feeling great. I look really, really shiny. Excuse my dog. Aside from that, the coverage still looks good. The left side still looks a lot more natural and less cakey. The right side definitely looks a little cakey. As far as the hives go, I still have like a little reaction going on, or it's like a little breakout or something. Not sure, maybe it's the foundation, but I didn't notice it prior to the foundation being applied. I definitely think you should stick to, sorry guys, my dog. As far as which side of my face looks better, this side definitely looks a little bit more cakier, and the reaction is going down a little bit. I don't know why. I don't know if the foundation is making me break out. Maybe it's a new foundation or something I didn't notice prior to applying it. And the left side of my face seems fine, so it might not be the foundation. Just take that as it is. The left side of my face definitely looks a lot better, so I highly advise using a brush. Foundation doesn't sink into my fine lines. It's a little pory, just a little bit. Sinking into the pores, not really much. I mean, most of it still looks pretty good. I think you could still go without a primer with it. It's not staying around my nose area for sure. That's worn off and it's not doing well with the oil. So as far as being super oily, I would stray away from this unless you really feel like keeping on it with a powder, which I don't know if anyone really wants to. So I think this would be a lot better for those with normal to drier combination skin. Or maybe this foundation would be a lot better in the winter if you get less oily then. So that is my first impression of the Too Faced Born With It foundation. It has really good coverage. The shade looks really good on me. It's a decent price tag as far as foundations go in Sephora, but I don't think the oily skin though didn't wear well for that. Aside from the whole oily skin thing, I don't have any other problems with it. Packaging's really, really cute. Nothing else to say really. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Keep the requests coming in because I love hearing them. And I'll see you guys in a later video. I seriously need a touch up though. With a touch up, it looks way better, by the way. Way better. Touch up, girls.